watching Belly. Godson, I could see they study Machiavelli. Peanut butter pins, got them jelly at the deli. If you feeling like a ninja, I got a machete. Hell yeah, them girls bad, but the fuck.
Hey, what is up, YouTube? It is your Tatted Up Queen, Chrissy Andrew, back at it again with another video. Thank you guys for choosing my channel today. And for those of you who are new, welcome. Hit that subscribe button down below because you don't want to be anywhere but here, okay? So, as you guys can see, based on today's thumbnail and title, I'm giving you guys seven signs, okay? Seven signs that he or she is way too toxic for you, all right? I'm just letting y'all know now, y'all don't deserve it. It took me a while to realize these things. I'm not even joking, okay? I put myself in many situations that I could have gotten out of. But, you know, we live and we learn these things that we have to go through sometimes. So, I have my handy-dandy notebook with my seven signs written down because y'all know I can't remember nothing for nothing. And we're just going to get right into the video. But before we do that, please give this video a thumbs up so that I know that you like it. Duh. Comment down below how you feel, whether you agree with me, whether you disagree, whatever the case may be, put it down below. And then if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. You can either do it now or wait till we finish the video. But I know that y'all feeling me, so just do it now. Do it now. Go ahead. And while you at it, I'm chatting, click that notification bell so that whenever I upload, you guys get notified. Hello? Like, come on now. But moving right along, getting into the video, the things that I have written here is not in any order or anything like that, but I just have it written down. So the first thing I have is no support, all right? Jumping right into it, y'all. I told y'all, boom, off the bat. The first sign of you knowing that you're with somebody who's toxic is that they are not supportive. If you are interested in whatever it is that you're interested in, and like I said, guys, this is for a male or a female. So whether you're a guy dating a girl dating a guy, girl, whatever the case may be, these are signs for you to know that he or she is too toxic. But yeah, definitely no support. The person that you're with has to prove to you that they are supportive by just saying, like, you know, giving you some constructive criticism or, you know, some encouraging words before you go perform or whatever it is that you're interested in. Like, if you dance, if you do hair, if you cook, if you play ball, if you swim, if you do YouTube, if you have a podcast, which you guys should go listen to, by the way. I'm gonna leave the link down below. But yeah, whatever it is that you're doing, whatever it is that you're interested in, the person that you're with doesn't necessarily have to be interested in the same thing, but it would be nice to have some, you know, support from your significant other or the person that you're with. They don't even have to be that significant, but damn, like, let me know that you notice what I'm doing. Like, yo, babe, that was real nice, you know, I like what you did. Or, yo, go ahead, go break a leg. Or, you know, come to my games, come to my shows, watch a video, listen to a podcast, something like that. Let me know that you here, that we here, you know? Next, the second sign is never happy for you. I can't stress this enough. And I'm gonna put never happy for you / jealousy because there's plenty of times that I've been in a relationship with somebody and they were never happy for me. Like, if I got a good grade on a test, if I passed my class, when I won a dance competition, what else? When I bought something new for myself, when I closed a credit card. Like, it could be the smallest things. If this person is not happy for you, like, at all, and always, you know, well, yeah, I'm happy for you, but what about me? That kind of thing. That person is not for you. Because just like if the person is supposed to be supporting you, they're also supposed to be happy for your accomplishments or just happy for you in general. So if you notice that, like, dang, he ain't never happy for me, or dang, she always got an attitude whenever I do something good. Like, what the hell? That's how you know this person is not for you, okay? Next, number three. Controlling. Oh my goodness, I had a boyfriend once. He was very controlling, okay? He didn't want me talking on the phone with anybody. He didn't want me hanging out with anybody. There were certain things I couldn't wear. And I dubbed that real quick. I had to let him know, listen, we're not married. And even when we are married, if that was even going to happen, this is not the way I want to live my life. Because the same way you can have friends and you can do whatever you want, I should be able to do the same thing. Right? So if that person is controlling, oh, don't talk to this person. Don't hang out with these people. Oh, no, you're not going here. Who said you could wear that? Dub that, okay? Because he or she is not your parent. The only people that can control that is you, okay? Next, number four, mentally, physically, verbally abusive. First of all, in any relationship, whether it's a guy and a girl and a guy, or the same sex, relationship, nobody should be putting their hands on anybody. So if you're physically abusive, off rip, that's a dub. Don't put your hands on me, because I will go to jail, okay? But if this person is mentally and verbally abusing you, I can give you guys an example. Mental abuse is like messing with you. Like, oh, you ain't never going to be nothing, you know? That's like messing with your head. Like, dang, I'm never going to be anything. Or you ain't never going to succeed. Because you know, some people, they don't have a strong backbone. So some people really start to believe that stuff, and they really start to think like, damn, like maybe he's right or maybe she's right. Ain't nobody gonna love you but me. Like, you know, things like that. Some females and some males, they really start to think like, dang, I think he or she is right. I'm gonna listen to him or her. And, you know, so it's sad. And then because it's messing with your mental, you know, that's also that's also verbal abuse, because they're speaking to you. It's like they're not, you know, they could not be hitting you or whatever the case may be, but verbal abuse is just disrespect. Oh, F you, SMD, I hate you, I hope you die. You like stuff like that. You don't need that in your life. I'm telling you, if you are going through that, please seek help if it's not easy to leave. But that's how you know you're dealing with somebody toxic. And that is not what anybody needs, male or female. That's just too much. That's too much. Next is number five, cheating, lying, and stealing. I know everybody watching probably has a story where they've gotten cheated on, or maybe cheated. They've gotten lied to. They've been lied to or lied, or they've been, you know, somebody stole from them, or they stole, whatever the case may be. I'm hoping that you're not going through that now. I'm hoping that you're not doing that now. But this is how you know when somebody is toxic. If this person is constantly cheating on you, that person is not for you. And I honestly should have took my own advice that I'm giving y'all now and just left it alone. But, you know, like I said, some people, everybody goes through their different things. You live and you learn. So I learned. I lived. But yeah, if the person is cheating, toxic. The person is lying to you, like, oh yeah, babe, I'm gonna go to the gym, but they really with so-and-so, dub that. And stealing. Why is the person that you with stealing from you? If you and I are together, you should be like comfortable enough to come to me and ask me for whatever it is that you need. Because 9 times out of 10, I'm gonna say no. But nah, 9 times out of 10, I'm gonna say yeah, you know, especially like if you my dude or my girl or whatever the case may be, come to me. Yo, babe, can I get this real quick or whatever? Even if you're not coming to me on the intentions of, you know, like if you're borrowing money, hey, babe, can I borrow $20? Okay, cool. Don't go in my bag and take it and then I gotta find out that it's missing. Or, you know, don't go taking my clothes. Like, I don't understand why people do that. But yeah, leave that alone. Number six, oh my God, if this person is manipulative, leave. Manipulative people, I swear, are the most toxic people you can ever think of, because they have a way of not even being like physically abusive, but I feel like this goes into everything above, because they're being manipulative, which means they're verbally abusing you, mentally abusing you, because they're messing with your mental. They're speaking to you real disrespectful, but they trying to switch up things. Manipulative is like, I'm pretty sure y'all know the meaning, but it's when they have a way of manipulating you into getting what they want for their benefit. So if you can like see the signs and catch on to things like that, don't let that go unnoticed. For real. Nip that in the bud right then and there, because that person will continue to do the same thing over and over, because they're gonna be like, bro, she ain't realize, or he ain't peep, cool. Yeah, let me get another $20 on top of that. Or, yeah, let me drive your car for another 600 miles. Like, you know, just little things like that. And last but not least, number 7, sneaky. I'm pretty sure everybody has a story of them dealing with somebody who was sneaky or them being sneaky. I mean, I can't be honest. I've had my fair share of sneaky moments when I was in a relationship. And I'm going to be honest, but I've grown up. But, you know, plenty of people that I've dated were very, very sneaky. I'm talking about with the phone, with their whereabouts, their friends, their houses. Like, there's no reason for you to be sneaky if you and I are dating. But that's all I have for y'all today. Those are my 7 signs if you're dating somebody's toxic. I hope that you enjoyed my video. If you agree, don't agree, if you got any comments, whatever the case may be, please leave those down below in the comment section. Before you leave, I hope that you subscribed already. Did you? Make sure you subscribe right now and give this video a thumbs up. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.